So we're going to look into the different options that we have when we link media into Mistika Project. We've seen before how we can drop into the timeline and consequentially into our Mistika Project clip. But right now, what I'm going to show you is how we can have a split view of our browser. And you can see here that both of them are in the project. In this case, I'm going to show the data folder here, which is where, as I've said in some other videos, the bulk of our work in our Mistika project will happen. And in this window that you can see that as soon as I clicked it highlights in green, I'm going to navigate to where my media is. And in this media, we could see how different clips. So I have this clip over here, and I'm going to import it and just say import load file, just as we've said before. This would be a third option, and we could see how in our project we have LNK file dot LNK file. That LNK file is going to refer to the shot we just linked. This case, I'm going to get rid of this LNK file. Right, because what I really want to do is actually link all these shots. So over here in this render folder, let's do it from the mob folder. Might be better. I'm gonna go to import and say import all movies. As I can see here, I have different options like import all sequences, import all media, or import all movies. In this case, what is going to happen is that as I've got only mob files inside there, I could say import all media and it wouldn't matter. So let's click on that. And I have the import sequences and movies menu here, window. It will ask me at what path do I want to create all the links. If I really want to change this, I can change it and go and say, hey, just keep some movies here. Okay, and it's going to ask me if how I want to generate a specific clip name if I wanted to. This really depends if you have any folder structure that you really want your clip name or your tape name to inherit, and obviously this is related to any policy that you might have when you are doing a project. And over here at the bottom, we have different options. It depends if we are linking a folder where there's a multiple links. If we want to replicate the folder tree, in this case, I'm not going to do it. We're going to use another example to view this. And if the media is interlaced, in this case, it isn't. It's going to be progressive media. And I have two options, import and load. Or import. In this case, import, what the only thing it's going to do is just going to create a folder called movies, exactly as we said in our data folder of our project. Okay, and we can see we have all our links here. I'm going to minimize this window. That was the previous link that we had before that we see in the timeline. And you can see here, as soon as I click on a clip, we could see the actual shot in our source monitor. And obviously, over here, then I can grab the shots and drop them into the timeline. If I zoom out, we could see all of them in here.